All hail the beard, it's your boy Big Beard B, and we back for another edition of Big Beard Business. Today we're here with yet another fragrance review, and this time we have a newer fragrance. Yes, we're talking about one of the 2020 releases from the house of Parfum de Marly, and that fragrance is none other than the fragrance Greenly. I know a lot of people out there have been talking about the latest release, which is Pegasus Exclusif, one of the ones I can't wait to get my nose on, but I do have this gem with me here today. Now, what I will tell you is this fragrance was sent to me from the house of Parfum de Marly, but if you've been on this channel for any period of time, then you know I talk about this company a whole lot, all right? Hell, I am excited to bring this to you, but as always, all opinions, views, thoughts, breaking of boxes, etc., are of my own. So now that we got that out of the way, let's get down to Big Beard Business. Now, your presentation for Greenly looks something like this. As you would imagine, the box will look, doesn't matter, okay? Doesn't matter what the box looks like. The only thing that matters is this juice. So let's see what we get here. Now, with the other release that we got this year, which was the re-release of a fragrance that I really enjoy, Sedley. This one here is, boom, there you have it, all right? Good distribution. Look at that thing. It's like a little shotgun blast. Bow, bow, bow. All right, man, here we go. So this fragrance here, to me, is definitely something that is better suited for the spring and summer. Now, this one to me is a fresh, fruity fragrance, although I think it's all purpose and can be used indoors if you are in the fall or winter. I think that you're really going to get the best performance out of this fragrance, or the best wearings out of this fragrance, if you rock this one in the spring and or summer. Now, the initial release of this fragrance came out around that time, so it was right in line with when you should be rocking this fragrance, and we rarely see that from companies. You see typically that they release it ahead of when you should be wearing it. That way it's in the people's hands and within their households as the seasons come about. But I digress. Your bottle for this fragrance is your traditional heavy style bottle that you get with Parfum de Marly, and also the cap remains the same. In terms of the juice here, let's talk more so with what you get in the notes here. Obviously, there's three stages. You have the top, you have the heart, and then you also have the base. Let's go through and see what we get here. Now, as I mentioned, this fragrance is this fresh, fruity fragrance, and as expected, the notes kind of fall in line. In the top of this fragrance, we have Sicilian bergamot, we have mandarin, we have green apple, and you also have cashmere wood. In the heart, we have cedarwood, we have violet, we have peregrine, and we have palmarose. And finally, in the base, we have oak moss, musk, and a amber wood accord. And on first spray of this fragrance, you're gonna get something that is fresh, inviting, and lively. As I mentioned, with this fragrance, you get a fresh, fruity fragrance that is really primed to do well in the spring and summer, which is a bit of a change from the house, at least in my personal opinion. When I think about Parfum de Marly fragrances, I really think about the heavy hitters, ones that are out there for this time of year. If you're watching this video in fall or winter, when I talk about this time of year, this is what I'm talking about. They really have really built their brand, at least to me, on standout fragrances for the fall and winter, with the Leightons, the Harrods of the world, and we have seen them begin to really dip and dabble into the spring and summer realm. I'm not saying that they don't have any, but because they actually do. One of my favorites out there is Galloway, and it's really that musky fragrance. Comes in a white bottle, one that you may be familiar with, and obviously I've talked about Sedley a number of times on this channel, and one that I feel stands out. And this one here really takes that very same approach in being a fragrance that has some similarities, but also it's different in itself. And when I say it has similarities, it's just a familiar type of vibe, one that is super easy to wear, one that you won't feel complicated or challenged with wearing. You're gonna put this thing on and continue on with your day, head up, chest out, like a boss. To me, on the opening of Greenlee, again, this one is fresh. And to me, the key player, the star player in that opening, the LeBron James, is going to be that green apple. The apple just really just jumps off and begins to take a life of its own. It says, hey, I'm here. Welcome to my party. And by the name in itself, I would think that that makes complete sense. And I'm not sure if they named it Greenlee because of the apple, the green apple here, as obviously some of you may already know, this one had a different name, but this one is just re-released under this name of Greenlee. And I think it's aptly named because the green apple is definitely something you're going to get here without a question on first spray of this thing. Now, when you spray Greenlee, I would say first 5 to 20 minutes of this fragrance, the green apple note is like, hey buddy, I am here. Welcome to my party. Listen, you're definitely going to get the green apple there for sure. As this begins to transition and take life a bit more, you get that wood that comes in here, but that freshness from the bergamot and the green apple is still there alive and well. That mandarin plays a part there too, but I believe that the green apple, some of the bergamot for added hint of freshness, and then also some woody components really begin to really build up this fragrance to be what a fragrance that I find to be super enjoyable. Now, as I mentioned, this fragrance has some violet in the mid here, and I don't feel that the violet within this fragrance really gives off this powdery feel as violet can do within fragrances, but it really provides this airy, dewy type of vibe to the fragrance that is something I feel is super needed in this scent. And a lot of fragrances that have that spring and summer aspect of it tend to miss it. They either go too far in the citrus side, too far in the fruitiness, and they really leave out that wispy, airy type of feel that you need in a scent, and they did a magnificent job bringing that into Greenlee. Now, when I think of violet within fragrances, it has some added aspects of sweetness there, and you're gonna definitely get that in this fragrance here, but it's not gonna be anything that's like super sweet. I think the mixture of the violet, some of the wood here, and also again that green apple provide this slightly tart sweetness that's airy, wispy, dewy, and it just really works on, I don't know how they do this. Like, I'm not like a perfumer myself, but when I think about kind of the notes and how they combine these things together, this here just really, really works. I think that the violet note that they add in this fragrance, they really did a good job in this, because what happens, as I already mentioned, that sometimes that violet comes off as powdery, and I've talked about fragrances that I really enjoy with that has that powder feel. Think back to Burberry Touch, violet there, powder feel, musk, totally different vibe in a fragrance like this. And finally, in the base of this fragrance, some of those wood notes come into play, and some of that musk. Now, the musk in this fragrance is nothing like you're going to get in Galloway. So some of you felt that Galloway's musk was too much, but this one here is definitely toned down, it's refined, and it just adds a little oomph to this fragrance here in terms of, you know, adding some a bit of power to this scent in itself. One that I'm really happy to have in the collection, and I think another thing they did really good with this fragrance, and a lot of their fragrances tend to work in this way, is having solid performance. On this fragrance here, some of that opening in terms of projection here, it really gets good for the first 2 hours or so. When I think of fresh fragrances, that's really good all in all for what you get in terms of a lot of fresh fragrances out there. Traditionally, you'll get some of those notes that really go away as it opens, and then you immediately into the dry down in the base. But for me, with that freshness from the open, it really stays there for about 2 hours or so. And this one for me goes about 8 hours or so. Let's go 6 to 8 hours, I think, is a safe time frame to put on this fragrance. I've worn this one a number of occasions since I've had it within my collection, and I've obviously done my test strip testing and on skin testing and clothing testing, and I'm really happy with the performance on this scent overall. Now, in my dealings with Parfum de Marly fragrances, I know that sometimes they can be a bit more complex. They can have a bit more body and volume to them. But this one, to me, is a good entry-level fragrance into the brand. If you're looking to get a fragrance that is safe, you can pick this one up if you're in Florida, your California, places like that, or anywhere that you have a tropical, warmer weather fragrance wearing occasion, this is a fragrance that could work. If you're in any of those environments where it's more hot or warm or sticky, throughout the year. This is a fragrance that you are going to love. It could possibly be a signature scent. Again, I've talked about this one in the beginning, but if you were looking for a fragrance that could be year-round, this one could do it, but I think that this one could be best worn in the spring and summer. That's just my personal opinion if I'm rocking this thing. Now, all in all, solid fragrance, good performance, good longevity, solid. This is definitely going to be as usual as it comes to Parfum de Malle price points. All right, so you can look about $300 if you're looking to pick this fragrance up, and you know, it is what it is. I think this is what we expect when we think of Parfum de Malle price points, and I think that all of their fragrances, at least out of the, you know, 11 or 12 that I have within my collection from them, that's really on point in line with what they offer. And I personally believe that all of their fragrances fit at least that price point in itself. Super solid to have this one in the collection. I appreciate them sending this one to me. And if I had to give this one an official rating, man, I'm really tough on where I want to put this in between Sedley and this one here. As you guys know, I'm a huge fan of what they did with Sedley, the newer macerated version. But this one here is super solid as well. I think right now I'm going to kick this one out with an 8.5. I think for what this one is for, where I will wear this fragrance, it's definitely one that I'm super excited to have. And I think this one is a bit different than what you would expect from this fragrance. If you were just to look at this fragrance, you would probably think it's minty and you know, super minty type of situation. At least that's what I would get from this just by looking at it. But having this in the collection, obviously getting the name of it, getting that green apple star player of the show here, good fragrance in my humble opinion. If you have this one in your collection under this name or the previous name, let me know what your thoughts and opinions of this one. Do you enjoy it? Do you like it? Do you love it? Do you want some more of it? If so, comment down below and let me know. As always, I'm your boy, Big BB. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend that we are back again. Dropping reviews for you, man. Trying to help you smell great this fall, this summer, this winter. Hit the goddamn